does this. She was my girl.
I didn't know you were recording.
Say something right when I start recording. She said I'm a bitch. So this is going to be my review for Fear the Walking Dead Season 7, Episode 1, Beacon. Now, I guess right off the bat, to a degree, I will eat my words just a little bit because, coincidentally enough, the very last video, I did not even realize that the Fear Season 7 premiere was this Sunday. And on Saturday night, I made a video talking about how shitty Fear was. And specifically in that video, I was talking about how Strand just didn't feel right as a villain, or it didn't feel earned. And I still agree with that, that it should have happened back, you know, whenever he was first introduced. However, I guess I'll just try to be a little spoiler-free. I did like this episode a lot for the majority, and I did like Strand as a villain, just absolute apocalyptic pimp. See, the actor Coleman Domingo really just killed it in the role. You know, he just turned it up all the way, his charisma, and just how you would expect somebody like Strand, if they were going to go full out of a scale on 10 to an 11 of living the apocalyptic high life. Like, he was really only lacking the crown, like having a crown on. They went over the top with every detail, everything he did, you know, drinking the umbrella, and the strawberries, you know, the whole outfit, the medieval sword, you know, all the rings, just awesome. And actor's voices as well, just as a side note. So, this episode premiere was good. However, let's remember, last season, season 6 premiere was good too, with Morgan. You know, Morgan was like, yeah, Morgan Jones, you're dealing with somebody else now, badass. And then you get the whole season played out, and it's, you know, kind of, there was a lot good in season 6, as an interview for season 6, I'm just saying, there was a lot good in season 6, better than previous seasons, but overall, you know, it was just an improvement. It wasn't, like, just great, it was just better than what it was, and so I don't really have high hopes for the whole season, just because this one episode was particularly good for the most part, because that's how last season was, right? But no, so, anyway, we'll get into the specifics of this one. The intro was really, really cool. I like the whole Fallout scenery that we're getting, even if I think it's kind of unrealistic to have the bomb go off and everybody suddenly have a hazmat suit or something to make it with the radiation readers, meters, but whatever. It's still cool, I guess, to have the whole scenery change, for the most part, to look all, it's already been apocalyptic, but what I mean is irradiated, that's what I'm trying to say. Although, the area that they filmed in Fear, I feel like, has always looked irradiated anyway. There's no leaves on the trees, it's just desert and barren wasteland since, like, season 4. Let's see, so, yeah, you get the scenery, you get the dead fish, the fallout, you know, the sign, the walkers, some of them are the skins peeled off, and they're naked, which is really weird, but I guess they always try to do something extra with the villains, for the most part, where the villains all do something unique. So it looks like this particular villain group is stripping the walkers of their clothes to shame them. I don't know, but we'll see. It's just still something that's kind of intriguing. You know, I like it whenever he has to resort to eating the dead possum, or he's about to, and he breaks down and cries. I really like the character of Will, but spoilers, you know, that's how it went last season. I had the bounty hunter in the first episode of season 6, and I liked him, and they killed him. And then in this, they have Will, you start to like him, and they kill him. Just kind of unfortunate, but I did like the twist at the end. But anyway, we're getting ahead of ourselves. So, I put Will knows a lot about radiation, and everybody suddenly knows a lot about radiation, where they can survive. You know, the rain is bringing it out of the air. It's just like, okay, you know, I don't know, I think you all should be dead, or just, if this is really a nuclear bomb that just went off, but whatever, okay. Yeah, I already went over this, I'm reading off my notes, by the way, but I love Strand, just living the high life as a villain, just absolutely awesome. It should have happened earlier, and I still agree with most of the other stuff I said in that video, by the way, about some Fear of the reboot just being ridiculous, how they've done the whole total shift, and yeah, but anyway. So yeah, I already said how much I love Strand being the king of the apocalypse. And then, so some of my biggest problems with this episode, I think, is the dialogue between Strand and Will. I'm talking particularly in whenever he had the gun on him. I don't know. I have it several times. A lot of the dialogue between Strand and Will is that poetic crap dialogue that Walking Dead has been famous for in the later seasons, unfortunately. The main show's gotten better with it with Angela Kane. But, yeah, some of this shit between Strand and Will, I'm just like, what the fuck are you saying? You know, this is so... Nobody talks this way, you know? I'm talking about, like, the dialogue, like, oh, you know, I had to find Alicia so I could prove to myself that I can be a better person. And I thought if I could save her, then I would be redeemed for the things that I've done. But even she won't forgive me for the past. Like, what? I'm having to think too fucking hard and too deep about the shit you're saying. Just say it like it is. Just say, you know, I gotta find Alicia, you know. I gotta apologize to her. Last time I was with her, I did some really messed up shit, you know. And I just want to make sure she's okay. And fucking leave it at that, you know. Don't go so fucking deep into it. I mean, sometimes I guess it's alright, but this was several times in this episode. So that's probably my biggest overall complaint for this one. It was very rich and laid on between the two of them. There was a scene in here that I appreciate when you were there trying to start up. Just little details. This reminded me. I like the scene when Will kills the walker and he has his radiation mask on. You can see the zombie in the mask, the reflection. That was cool. But I like whenever they're about to burn the diesel in the lighthouse to get the light going. Will says, or Strand says, you know, it's got like a 1 in a million chance that diesel's going to burn, you know, and it burns anyway. But I appreciate that they at least say stuff like that, because at this point in the apocalypse, you know, I think about those things. And you can still do it, as long as you acknowledge it, at least. I bet you some slack. So they did, they acknowledge that. And I do like the unique way that they were doing the spotlight in the fog so Strand could see. And then they were trying to look for Alicia as well, and I guess it's super foggy because of the radiation or whatever. And I like the hotel being completely destroyed. I did find it a little odd that Strand couldn't find where this hotel was at up until Will came along, and then he was like, oh yeah, the hotel. I don't know, maybe I missed something there, but I did think that was a little odd. Strand's always asking this repetitive question, why did you save me? Why did you come back for me? I can hear him saying that so many times throughout the series. And, yeah, he should have been dead a long time ago, for being honest. I don't know why so many people saved Strand either. I'm wondering the same thing that he's wondering. Yeah, why the fuck did you save him? Yeah, more BS dialogue through here. Whenever they find the fucking note that says, you know, Will, and then it's got Padre inside. Just being so weird, the way nobody really is, I don't think, in real life. I put a big note on here for this one. What the fuck are you guys talking about? The way Will won't straight up answer the question. What is Padre? Oh, it doesn't matter, you know, anymore now. It'll matter if I find her, you know, but it's going to get a lot of people killed. What the fuck are you saying, you know? It was smart. I like the way they used the walkers to tow the lighthouse piece back to where they're going. And then I do like Strand's whole idea, you know. It does make sense what he's saying whenever Dakota's group, their faults, and Morgan's group's faults has been because of their love or their care for people and all that. So he's getting super dark, using the lighthouse beacon to bring the walkers in, to keep people out. It is a nice thought process, and I do like it. It's just, at the same time, you got to think, Strand, you can't leave, though, can you? How can you leave? If you're keeping people out, then that's also keeping you in. So I guess we'll have to see what's up with that. I don't know. But let's see. Maybe it's just running to the front, and then they can get out the back. I don't know. But I do like his mindset here and how dark he goes, because it seemed like, I was thinking, okay, I can see them doing this with Strand. Will they eventually redeem Strand at the end of the season? Because he gets up with Alicia, he turns good again. But no, I'm thinking at the end of the season, they're probably going to have to kill Strand. The writers will. Maybe this will be probably the second to last season. And I'm thinking they'll kill him off, you know. I mean, I know Coleman Domingo, I'm pretty sure he's very involved with AMC and the show. But whenever he kills Will and pushes him off, you know, unfortunately, I did like the character, but I was like, okay, this is really dark. It's pretty much the last nail in the coffin. The Strand was right. He said, Alicia's not going to forgive me for this. He's self-aware. does, though, I'm so over it at this point. All the great strain's gotten. If she does, and she's like, you know, I'll do it for my mom or some crap like that. Yeah, I'll still keep watching it, but that's I'm really gonna fucking hate that. I do like Will's shot at the end when he comes up as the walker after he got his head completely busted. So yeah, overall, I was enjoying this episode apart from the dialogue, but that's not really me coming to light and saying, oh, Fear's completely changed. Like I said, because season 6, episode 1 was totally badass as well, and we can just take a sharp turn from here, you know. Even though, again, it is getting better, it's just overall not that good, you know. It's just made some really bad decisions in the past that they can't really make up for, you know. So yeah, that's what I got for this episode. Let me know what you thought of it.